Hello, and in this video, I'll be going over how to set up interrupts on a PIC microcontroller. First, I'm going to go over the physical hardware connections. I have two LEDs connected to RB7 and RB6, and then two switches connected to RB0 and RB1 with pull-down resistors, and then the switch connected to VDD. Well, let's get to coding. First, what we want to do is set up our inputs and outputs with TRISB bits dot RB0 equals 1 for input. Copy this line. Let me change RB0 to RB1 to make it also an input. Let me copy the lines again. We change RB1 to 7 and the second one to RB6, and we make them 0 for output. Then we just set our outputs low with lat b bits dot RB7 equals 0 and RB6 equals 0 as well. Next, we create our interrupt service routine function, which is going to be type void interrupt high ISR, and we're passing no parameters. Now, this can be any name that you would like it to be. Now, we are going to refer to the data sheet. Now, this PIC has two interrupt vectors available, one located at hex 8 and the other located at hex 18. Hex 8 is the high priority interrupts, while hex 18 is the low priority interrupts. This data sheet has a nice little diagram that shows how the interrupts are set up. The first interrupt we're going to do is interrupt external interrupt 0, which is referred to as INT0. Now, this goes through an AND gate and an OR gate and then to the high priority interrupt. This is a dedicated high priority interrupt. Now, to set up the interrupt, we first go to the INTCON register. We copy the name and the first two bits we want to set: global interrupt enable bit 7 and then 6. First, we declare int con bits dot global interrupt enable high member equals 1, and then global interrupt enable low member equals 1. Next, we want to enable our interrupt priorities, which is done via the rcon register, which is way down. The interrupt priority is then enabled by rcon bit 7 ipen. We copy rcon, paste rcon bits dot ipen equals 1. Now we go back to the INTCON register and we find the external interrupt 0 enable bit, which is located in bit 4 of the register. Add above enable bits. Then we say int con bits dot int0 IE, which is the enable, equals to 1. Now, the next thing is to set up the edge trigger for the interrupt, which is located in INTCON 2. Scroll down, go to INTCON 2 register. We find int edge 0, which will set if our interrupt is active on rising or falling edge. Since the switch is pulled down, we want a rising edge to activate the interrupt. So we go back to our code, intcon 2 bits dot int edge 0 equals 1. Now, the next thing we want to do is populate our interrupt service routine. First, we start by disabling the global interrupts, and then when we exit the routine, we enable the interrupts again. Now, every time the button is pressed, a flag will be set for that specific interrupt. So in the case, this will be if incon bits.int0if is true, then toggle the LED by setting lat b 7 not equals lat b7, and then the flag has to be cleared in code by setting it to 0. Let me program the pick. Now, when the white button is pressed, the green LED will turn on. And then again, turn off. Now, there isn't much debouncing in this, so you might get a double trigger, as shown by the green LED turning on and off. Next, what I'm going to do is show how to set up a low priority interrupt. First, we have to declare the function for the routine. It's also a function of type void interrupt. Now we add the keyword low priority, which I can't spell to save my life, so I'm just going to copy paste from my pre-written code. And we call it low ISR. And we're not passing parameters to it, so it's void. Now we add the interrupt disable, and then at the end, the re-enable. Now we go down to our main code again, and we refer back to the datasheet. I'm going to do external interrupt 1 on the low priority side of the interrupt. Now INT2, it needs the INT2 IE bit enabled, which is located in the INTCON3 register as bit 4. Now we go back to our code and we add INTCON3 bits dot IF1 enable equals 1. Then we set the priority bit, which is located in INTCON3 as well, on bit 7. Now 1 equals high priority interrupt and 0 equals low priority interrupt. So next thing we do is say INTCON3 INT1 priority equals 0 to set it to the low priority interrupts. Next we set up the edge trigger bit, which is located in the INTCON2 register. And that will be INT edge 1 equals 1 for high edge trigger. Next, we copy the code from our high priority interrupt, paste it in, then our interrupt flag is located in the INTCON3 register. So we change this to INTCON3 and then INT1IF, and then we copy this over to reset the flag again. Then we change the bit to LATB6 and is equals to the inverse of LATB6. Now we program the pick again. Now if the green button is pressed, the blue LED will toggle. Now again, there is no debouncing in this code, so you might get some erratic behavior from it. And again, white button is pressed, the green LED will light on and off, or toggle. To recap the code, first what we do is we set RB0 and RB1 as inputs, and then we set RB7 and RB6 as outputs. Then we set LB7 and LB6 low, so the LEDs won't burn. Next, we enable the interrupt priorities by setting RCON bits IPEN to 1. Then we enable in RCON3 the external interrupt 1 bit, and then set the priority of the external interrupt to 0, which is the low priority bit, and then we set the edge trigger as rising edge. Then we set the external interrupt 0 enable bit located in INCON, and then we set edge trigger bit to rising edge. Then we enable global interrupts high bit and the low bit. After that, we created our interrupt service routine for the high priority interrupts. Then we disable the interrupts. Then we test if the flag is set for external interrupt 0. And if it is set, toggle LB0. Then after the LED has been toggled, clear the flag. And then when we exit the routine, re-enable the global interrupts. And for the low priority interrupts, it is practically the same, besides that we check external interrupt 1's flag in INTCON3, and then we toggle LB6 on and off, and then we clear the external interrupt 1 flag. And that's a basic introduction to how to use interrupts on APIC. A like, share, comment, and subscription would be greatly appreciated. Any equipment that I have used will be linked down in the description. Any code that I have written will be linked on my Git. Thank you, and have a nice day.